Brownian movement.
What is this?
When the colloidal solution in the dark room is observed at right angles to the direction of light with a high power microscope, ultra microscope, then we can see that the colloidal particles in the solution as a bright stars moving in zigzag motion. When the colloidal solution is observed at right angles to the direction of light in the dark room, the colloidal particles in the solution appear as bright spots moving in zigzag motion. This type of zigzag motion, that means this type of randomless zigzag motion, is called Brownian movement. It was first observed by the scientist Brownian. So, Brownian movement. So, see here, what is Brownian movement? The constant zigzag motion of colloidal particles, the constant zigzag motion of colloidal particles is called Brownian movement, because it is observed by the scientist Brown. That's why it is named so. What is the reason for Brownian movement, and Brownian movement is affected by which factors? See here, Brownian movement is this Brownian movement, let it be in short BM, okay? BM means Brownian movement. This Brownian movement is directly proportional to temperature. That means when the temperature of solution is increased, the particles move more rapidly with more velocities. That's why Brownian movement, this constant zigzag motion of colloidal particles increases with increase in temperature. Next, how is it affected by size? You know, Brownian movement is inversely proportional to size of colloidal particles. Whatever be the colloidal solution, there will be Brownian movement. But this movement varies from one solution to one colloidal solution to another colloidal solution. So, how does it depend on size? Because I said earlier that colloidal particles have in the range 10 power minus 9 meters to 10 power minus 6 meters. If there is increase in the size, Brownian movement decreases. If there is increase in the size, there is decrease in the Brownian movement. Similarly, how is this related to viscosity? So, to viscosity also it is inversely proportional. If the dispersion medium is more viscous, then particles cannot move easily. So, with viscosity inversely, with size of DP particles inversely, with temperature directly. So, what is Brownian movement? This is a colloidal particle. In the colloidal solution, it moves first in this direction. After this, in this direction. See, the direction continuously it is changing. There is no perfect direction, one direction for it. It changes continuously. So, in that way, a colloidal particle moves in zigzag motion. So, this zigzag motion of colloidal particle is called Brownian movement. Now, let us see the reason for Brownian movement. The reason for Brownian movement is continuous collisions by particles of DM. particles of dispersion medium DM. You know that a colloidal particle being bigger, it tries to settle down. The colloidal particle being bigger tries to settle down in the colloidal solution. But what happens? You know, solvent molecules also move very rapidly. Because solvent molecules in comparison with the DP particles, very smaller. That's why solvent molecules are very rapid. Solvent molecules move very rapidly than DP particles. This rapid movement of a solvent, rapid movement of a solvent molecule, that means dispersion medium molecules, continuously collide these particles. Solvent molecule just hit the DP particle. Then it moves some, it changes its direction. There also it tries to settle down, but there also some solvent molecules hit it. Solvent molecules hit it. Then it moves in some other direction. So, it in this way, it continuously under the collisions by solvent molecules. That's why it moves in different directions, zigzag motion. So, this type of zigzag motion of colloidal particles by the continuous collisions by dispersion medium is called a Brownian movement. Next, this Brownian movement leads to the stability of, it has stirring effect. This Brownian movement has stirring effect. Why it is stirring effect? These collisions by dispersion medium continuously changing the direction of colloidal particles. That's why it moves in different directions, na? That causes a stirring effect, which is responsible for the stability of colloid. Which is the responsible for the stability of colloid. This Brownian movement is responsible for the stability of colloid. How it is responsible? If no Brownian movement, what happens? Simply the DP particles of dispersed phase, simply settle down. If all the colloidal particles in the solution settle down, that is nothing but coagulation. Then a colloidal solution does not exist. It becomes a suspension. Okay, so aggregation of particles takes place. Already a colloidal particles is aggregated. If these two aggregates combine, it becomes so bigger particle. That bigger particle, because of gravity effect, simply settles down. So colloidal solution does not affect if there is no Brownian movement. So Brownian movement is responsible for the stirring effect, which is responsible for the stability of a colloid. Okay, so this is about a Brownian movement.